Today is the 347th day that the Immanuel man-child Mahershala Kushbaz and his twin sister Rachel have been in the womb for the fourth stroke. Yahweh continued to draw out his dual nostrils, continuing to shorten the days through this 1260-day process of bringing forth this man-child and his three siblings according to his Revelation chapter 12 prophecy for the revelation of his two sons of his holy anointing realm. It's all quite remarkable. Strong's number 347 is in the Hebrew, is the word for Job. Job means the hated. Count those 42 chapters of Job, the count of affliction, are for prophecy for the here and the now. And Yahweh's affliction of his second son of his holy anointing, well, quite amazing. Who he sending forth these first four offspring of his Isaiah chapter 6 holy seed in the manner he is to cause me to be the hated. It's amazing. And, of course, just instead of me telling you that you're deceived and you're of your father Satan, causes me to be the hated. You don't want to be told the truth. You just don't want to be told that you're deceived. And you don't have dual ears to hear and dual eyes to see. So it makes me the hated. Shoot the messenger. That's what he called. Angel, the word angel, is just the word Hebrew word for messenger. And the Greek word for angel is just the Greek word for messenger. Shoot the messenger. Amazing. That's what... After all, that's what our ancestors did to his other servants, the prophets, isn't it? They shot the messenger. Of course, they didn't have guns, so they just cut him in half, like with Isaiah and such. But anyhow, this is the testimony of Yahweh, my Elohim's words written upon the here and the now, and his end time son of Adam. His account of Job is as well, those 42 chapters, parallel to 42 months, and those 42 children that were rent by those two bears that day when Elijah's replacement, Elisha, at Bethel, the house of Elohim, when he called down those two bears and rent those 42 children that mocked him. Go you up, you bald head. Symbolic of me shaving off my hair per Ezekiel chapter 5. We even talked about Ezekiel chapter 5, that shaving off my hair in yesterday's video. But quite amazing. But today is the 107th day of my toothache affliction for the 21 days of Daniel's toothache affliction, which is remarkable in itself how this ties into something and something. Just thought of, we were approaching day number 123 in just 16 days. 16 days from today would be December 25th. Wow. Daniel's toothache affliction ended. His last day was day number 123, 23rd day of the first month, 123. Wow. Yahweh's messenger came the next day, 124. Amazing. Right, to see today's 11/3 plus 16 days, yeah, would be 119, which is December 25th. Wow, amazing. Excuse me, 11/19, which is December 25th. Truly amazing. But it's been three teeth that rotated around, and yesterday I talked about how he's given me some reprieve from it, and it hadn't been too bad here lately. I should keep my mouth shut. I also talked about 22 days from yesterday. Well, and then by time last night came around, it was actually late afternoon, they started hurting, but by time night came around, they were hurting pretty good. Two of them, the top and the bottom on the left, but then the third one that's been hurting off and on too, has been hurting less often, but it came in by this morning. All three of them, those three teeth, make me talk about bears, those two bears. I think about the three ribs that were between the teeth of the bear, of the second beast of Daniel chapter 7 and such, but the dual teeth, between the dual teeth, those three ribs between the dual teeth, the second bear, and what does that bear go and devour much flesh, how that ties into the here and the now. It's amazing. But these 107 days have been remarkable how they've woven into this, and it ties into three months and 17 days today, but 3 months and 18 days tomorrow, and 3 months and 19 days the next day, but amazing. However, my affliction has been much longer than these 107 days. Much longer. It really has been going on to different tiers and different degrees. These three teeth are... I've already... What are posted in the door? 11 teeth? These three teeth won't come out. They just... They don't seem like they're going to come out. They just are pain. But those other teeth came out. And I think there's 11 of them, right? 11 of them posted in the door at this point. So there's been 11 other toothache afflictions before these three. And it might be 10, but I'm pretty sure it's 11. Now these three just, like I say, they persist and they won't come out. So it's quite different. But different degrees. I mean, the frostbite on my feet that night, to going out to get supplies, and because the man said he was going to bring a snowmobile and chainsaw and didn't, and gave took his life on 625. The symbolism, all that's amazing. But it goes really all the way back to him spitting me out of the belly of the ocean traversing plane, his sign of the dove, aka his sign of Jonah. There would be no other sign given. And I even think about 14 days between those three doves. The first dove plus 14 was the third dove. And I was thinking on the way out here, I don't think there's a 14-day break, any other 14-day break recorded in the testimony of his word. The 14 years of his account of the flood was prophecy. It wasn't recorded directly. So I think it's only a 14-day period from the first dove to the third dove, the sign of the dove. That comes up huge with this 11-11 waypoint to 11-25, the third dove that I talked about in yesterday's video. But truly amazing. But different tiers of this sign of the dove. Different tiers of this affliction have been since then. And even just his house being destroyed on account of you stealing from him, the affliction that's associated with that and everything else, and the different degrees of the different affliction we've had on account of you stealing from him, even for supplies and such, and things for these children and different things, and the process of the rowing thing to now 110 treks. Today might be 111 with the rowing thing, maybe if I feel up to it. 111 treks, all the things with steamboat number 127. I forgot to check again before I started today if she blew yet. Going on 10 days when I checked this morning. It's at 2:37 p.m. today. It'll be 10 days, so I'm not sure. But amazing. All the 111s he's woven into this with his triple crown, that justify, I will be justified, says Yahweh. And those three crowns of these three man-child's penises being circumcised and Psalms 118 and stuff. But anyway, the sign of the dove, when he spit me out of the belly of the ocean traversing plain with his restored calendar, plus 8 years, 2,880 days, parallel on those three crowns, 96 on each row of those two, of those, each pillar, Yachin and Boaz, had two rows of 100 pomegranates, 200 pomegranates. But when Nebuchadnezzar's servant, Nebuzaradan, came to break them down, there are only 96 on each row. That is 192 per crown. Three rows would be 288, a tithe of 8 years on his restored calendar, 2,880. But 8 years, 7 months, and 5 days. And that Ark Throne waypoint, that when he spit me out of the belly of the ocean, Jerusalem plain, was on the same day he caused his servant David to bring up the Ark from Obed-Edom's house after the 3 months, and on 3:28. And in Jeremiah 3, he says his Ark's not going to be a factor here. His throne is. Anyway, 875 for these 8 years, 7 months, and 5 days is used 34 places for the 34 chapters. These are truths and other things, but it means well, the word for well, living waters and such gonna flow out, and the dual well. I mean, there's tons of prophecies the well. I'm not gonna get into it, but that equates to 3,095 days. The third Strong's number 3,095 is Strong's number 3,095 is used three places. It refers to the third stone of the second row of the breastplate of judgment. It's translated diamond, but everything's three tiers of everything. Threes, but the three tiers of those, there's three stones in each of those four rows and everything else paralleling everything. Carmel with Elijah. I mean, I just go on and on and on. These videos go so long, but anyway, it's amazing. But translated diamond, they think it probably means an onyx, but they don't know. But it comes from a word that means to strike. He's getting ready to strike you, strike you with the affliction he's stricken me with. But anyway, it means to strike. I had a man write me yesterday. It had been written before and admits several times referred to in these videos. Refer to him by name sometime. The name's Thomas. Hello, Thomas. Hopefully you watch this video, and hopefully you watch the next one, because I'll address the conversation we had last night for the public in the next video, that my replies to you and stuff. But he said, I've asked if I've been to a dentist. Or I think he said asked if I'm going. I forget how he worded it, but going to the dentist with this toothache affliction. Do you listen to any videos, Thomas? it would be sin to do so. I assured him that there was no way. on planet Earth that I would be going to a dentist or a doctor or anything else, because it's sin to trust another for our healing. Plus, I know why I'm being afflicted. I'm being afflicted in your stead. The testimony of his word says so. I mean, the account of Job says so. It's quite amazing. But I'll expand upon that in another video. But he said that he wrote me back and said, I'm putting Yahweh to the test. Like, this man and the rest of you testing Yahweh big time by testing his drawn-out dual nostrils by stealing from him. How long will he draw out his dual nostrils? Which is the two words, drawn-out dual nostrils, the two Hebrew words that mean, that they translate long-suffering. But how long will he draw out his dual nostrils on account of you stealing from him? And really, it's you afflicting his second son of his holy anointing oil, because he's afflicted me in your stead to shorten the days. But his servant Job is loaded with details that testify to this. And plus, throughout the testimony of his word, he explains that the affliction he's given me is in your stead as he shortens the days. So go to a dentist, try to circumvent Yahweh, and that's putting him to the test. He quoted me, Yeshua rebuking Satan. No, Satan are those of you who live by your own thoughts. Because you're programmed by your father, Satan. He's the one that programming in this world is from Satan. The programming of Yahweh is through the testimony of his word, which you, Thomas, and the rest of you are not living by every word he sent forth from his mouth. But throughout the testimony of his word, he explains this, that my affliction is what? So I'm going to circumvent it, go to the dentist, whatever, doctor, do so sin. Elijah prophecy with those three sets of 51 men, Ahaziah sent, and everything else, all about going to inquire of man's resources to Beelzebub, the master of the flies. Amazing. I'm putting him to the test by trusting him. He tells us that if we live by every word he sent from his mouth, he'll heal us. That's promise. So you mean to tell me I need to go to a doctor or to a dentist, and when I know that I'm seeking to live by every word he sent forth from his mouth? No, if he's afflicted me, I want to know, one, what I'm still not living by, so he'll stop afflicting me, or two, just let the testimony of his word testify to why he's afflicted me, which is your stead. And I have continued to seek whatever I'm doing wrong, fearfully, because I don't want to be the cause for it. But Job couldn't understand the cause either, could he? No. But yet Yahweh's word defines what the cause was. And is there anyone like my servant Job with his righteousness? Think about that. All the three tears in that boat, the three tears of his accuser, three tears of his accuser. What about those seven sacrifices of bull? Those three men happened to offer up seven bulls and seven rams, those 14 animals. Wow, we just talked about 14. And such testimony of his words written upon the here and now. What about Job's 14 sons, the seven that were taken away, the seven that were replaced, and the three daughters? And it's just $3 that replace and such. Anyway, in yesterday's video, I said that the descendants of your father, Satan, are behind me. When I say get behind me, but I did not explain it correctly. And as a matter of fact, as I was uploading the video, he gave me more understanding to see that Yeshua's charge to Peter to get behind him, Satan, was really an instruction for him to set his thoughts upon the word of Elohim, the pathway of the word of Elohim, and to walk according to the word of Elohim. Let that determine. See, Peter said to him, maybe you ought not go there. Maybe you ought to go to a dentist, huh? He said, yeah, no, Peter, you're a snare to me. Thomas, that's what you tried to be to me, a snare. Go to the dentist. A snare. Satan, snare, snare, snare. Stop trusting Yahweh and go to a dentist. Good advice, Thomas, you snare. Peter, you Satan. Good advice. Go to a dentist. Whatever. Tells me it ain't going to be now. It's going to be a few years from now. Okay. Okay, there's a name for that too. It's called Hananiah in the scriptures. But he thought it was going to be sooner versus later. Died in the seventh month. Anyway, truly amazing, but he was just telling him his instruction, and I'll prove that. In the video description box, I said something along the lines, if you actually get behind me, follow behind me, you will no longer be of your father, Satan. So I addressed it in the video description box, but I'm addressing it in this video. I spoke about Yeshua's admonishment to Peter, his rebuke, just recorded in John 21 in yesterday's video. After Yeshua prophesied to him that he was going to be bound by another, after those three tears of Peter, do you Do you love me? Feed my lambs. Peter, do you love me? Feed my sheep. Peter, do you love me? Feed my sheep. After those three strokes, he tells him that he's going to be bound by another and die the spiritual death of being bound by another and led where he ought not to go when he gets older. And Peter asked, he says, what about this fellow? Referring to John. And Yeshua charged back, what's that to you, Peter? If this man should tarry until I return. Referring to prophecy for St. John's, Arizona, outside of where Gateway's raised up his house. Anyway, it's prophecy, spoken in parables. What's it to you, Peter? What's it to you if this man should tarry? What did he say to him? You follow behind me, Peter. You get behind me. You follow behind me, Satan. You follow me. What's that to you? You're going to talk about this and that. What's that to you? You follow me. And according to the key of David, following him is the same as following me. It's following the word of Elohim in the flesh. Following the word of Elohim in your flesh. Does the word of Elohim tell you to go to a dentist, Thomas? Oh, and Luke was a physician. Luke was Saul of Tarsus' follower. No. It doesn't tell you to seek man's medicines. It says to live by every word that he sent forth from his mouth, and he'll heal us. It's just what it is. But anyway, in light of this, Peter, follow me. What's it to you, Peter? You follow me. And believe me, he didn't just say, good-see-goo. What's it to you, Peter? Why don't you come along and follow me? No, he turned to him and said, you follow me. He rebuked him, just like he rebuked him up the flagpole and down the other side. Peter, do you love me? You know all things, Master. You know, actually, he did know all things, and he knew that Peter was going to be led astray by another, Saul of Tarsus, and take where he ought not go. Come be a snare to me, Thomas. Send me to a dentist. Why don't you stop stealing from our maker so I can buy some more baby clothes for later on in these children's life and different things. I just don't know how this is going to get ordered, because that's really what we keep getting, things that we need and more food supplies and more baby clothes and such. But anyway, now you keep stealing from our maker. And you want to lecture me? That is his anointed, his second son, his holy anointed. Now, get behind me. Get behind me, Thomas. Follow behind me. But it's clearly a charge for Peter to follow behind the word of Elohim. Clearly, what he said, get behind me, Satan. Clearly a charge, follow. No, Peter, get behind me. Stop being behind Satan. Get behind me. That's what he said, get behind me, Satan. Anyway, this is even further exemplified in Matthew chapter 16, where he rebuked Peter. And that he then told Peter, after he said that he was a snare to him, and he doesn't have his thoughts set upon the things that are of Elohim, but of the things that are of man. After that rebuke, he said, if any man will come behind me. See, he went on, I don't know how I shouldn't see it. He just didn't let me see it till I was re-uploading the video. But if any man come behind me, let him deny himself and take up his pole and follow behind me. The word of Elohim, key of David. Substituting Yeshua's name for the name that he gave to his two sons of his holy anointing oil in Revelation 19:13, the word of Elohim. Because whosoever will save his life will lose it, and whosoever will lose his life for... So you want to save your life by going to a dentist or a doctor? Thomas, you're going to lose it. Yeshua said, so whoever wants to save his life will lose it. You want to go to seek man's help? You're going to lose your life, Thomas. And believe me, the Elijah prophecy testifies to this, and so does the rest of Yeshua's word. Because whosoever will save his life will lose it, and whoever will lose his life, be willing to die for my sake, Yeshua said. Take up your stake. Be willing to die. Be willing to die unto death. I can guarantee I would die of this toothache affliction before I would go to a dentist or any other situation with my heart or anything else. And whosoever will lose his life for my sake will find it. I'm willing to die for Yeshua's word. You're obviously not, are you, Thomas? Why don't you go to a dentist? Get behind me, Satan. Get behind me. What profit is a man that he should gain the entire world and lose his life? Talk about losing life again, still. Losing life, dying. Dying, losing life, lose his life, and referring to your eternal life. Or what will a man give in exchange for his own life? Well, let me tell you what, I'll give up a little short season of suffering, but and I'll go live in the wilderness, and even if not another dime is sent to keep his anointed, I'll remain in the wilderness. I have to, because he commands me to be here, and he commands you to be here too, because his word testifies that his holy mountain behind me is the holiest place on planet earth, and I'm to be seen before his face is three strokes a year. But plus he's told me to flee into the mountains now if the abomination of desolation has been revealed anyhow. So I'm obedience anyway. Verse 27, he goes on, because the Son of Adam will come in the glory of the Father. Keep in mind, he said, pick up your stake. Pick up your pole. He was killed. Yeshua was killed. So pick up your pole and be ready to die. Give up your life. It's what it is. Have you been to a dentist? Say, what? What are you smoking? No, you're just drunk. Drunk off the wine of your fornication, your maker. Anyway, because the Son of Adam will come in the glory of his Father with his messengers, and then he will reward every man according to his works. Did Yeshua do this? Oh, he's coming inside of me right now, and the reward for your works, whether to rebellion to him or obedience to him, are getting ready to be rewarded. I can think of Isaiah chapter 66. Before this man-child's cord goes forth, he's going to make good on his reward to his enemies. And his enemies are those of you who live in rebellion to the testimony of his word. His word says so. Verse 28, truly I say to you that there are some standing here that will not taste death and death until they see the Son of Adam coming in his kingdom. The kingdom, his throne here on earth. You think it's Yeshua? Yeshua said he had some things to tell them even the night before he died, but yeah, they couldn't handle it. Couldn't handle that time. They couldn't handle that. It was this going to be drawn out this long. They just couldn't handle it. And you just can't handle it. But I have to tell you anyway, because his word says. But this is clearly a prophecy for the here and the now, and it's accompanied in 6 days, because it goes into chapter 17 in the next verse. In 6 days, of my affliction ended, and my face is shining. And like yesterday, I talked about Elijah's face is shining on the 41st day. It doesn't say his face is shining. It says he wrapped his faces. Like Moses had to wrap his faces. So you have to understand that it's prophecy. He wrapped his faces at the end of those 40 days with that in relation to the, and after the refiner's fire, a thin, hushed voice. But my affliction is going to come to an end and yours is going to begin. It's just what it is on a seventh day after 6 days. But today is also day number 324 that the faithful witness, I said 347, Job for Meher and Rachel. It's day number 347 for the faithful witness twins, Uriah and Zechariah, to be in the womb of the wife, that the Revelation 12 wife that's fled in the wilderness upon the dual wings of a great vulture to bring forth the Emmanuel man-child, Meher Shalal Kushpas. 324, meaning the 24th day of the third month, 324, on the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel, was Moses' day number 7 of 40. Very significant. Today is day number 19 of these 40 days now that end on 11-24. 11-24 is day number 324 of the year on our Maker's Restored Calendar. You just can't make it up. 7th day for Moses, 19th day for me today. 7-19 was July 19th. What he sent me which was what was it? It was 4-28, which is 3 months and 28 days for Feast of First Fruits, which I thought he was going to do all this, but no, he had some more things to uncover. He had to still send forth the Emmanuel man-child, Meher Shalal Kushpas, didn't he? I hadn't even heard of him. But he kept things from me, just like he keeps things from you. He blinds who he wants to blind and whatever he wants to blind. So it's amazing. But today is 11-3 on our Maker's Restored Calendar, and mirrors the reviling of his Meher Shalal Kushpas prophecy, which was on 11-3 on Satan's calendar. Take that which pertains to the Emmanuel man-child, Meher Shalal Kushpas, right on a great mirror, Isaiah 8, verse 1. But the reviling was on 9-11, 3 years ago. Actually, 3 years and 52 days ago, for the 52 days to build up the wall. He took 52 years to build up the three tiers of the boat. And then Noah and his family had to wait 14 years. But amazing. I told you truck number 111 might be today. Huge. Thomas, you've seen a few 111s just yesterday, right? 111 might be truck today. I don't know. We'll see how I feel. Also, steamboat number 127 might be today. We'll see how I feel. The bottom line is, get behind me, Satan. Or else you're going to be receiving the punishment of Yahweh's servant Satan. Just like I said, with Peter the glorified Elohim with his spiritual death, following Saul of Tarsus, Satan's boy, glorified Elohim, and believe me, he'll be glorified in your death as well, just like he'll be glorified with Satan being bound and later being destroyed, but after the 1,000 years. But get behind me, Satan. Otherwise, be prepared to be a partaker of our Maker's hot indignation.